Miss America 2.0 crowned the first winner of its first post-scandal competition on Sunday. After weeks of competition, Nia Imani Franklin earned the Miss America 2019 title and a $50,000 scholarship at Atlantic City's Jim Whelan Boardwalk Hall, the birthplace of the 1921 competition. Dancing with the Stars judge Carrie and Inaba and TV personality Ross Matthews hosted the show on ABC. Here's what you need to know about the event. The swimsuit portion was eliminated, among other rebranding. Miss America 2.0, as it was rebranded this year in the wake of the hashtag MeToo movement and a series of scandals. Not only eliminated the controversial swimwear portion for the first time in its 98-year history but also aimed to delve deeper to find its latest winner. Rather than judging the women solely on their outward physical appearance, the erstwhile pageant has also been made over as a competition full of candidates and not contestants, said Miss America organization chairwoman Gretchen Carlson. The former Fox News personality who won the title in 1989. The competition is now working to empower young women through education and service. 51 women representing all 50 states and the District of Columbia competed in preliminary contests earlier in the week. And during the final show, the remaining candidates were judged on their preliminary composite score, 25%, their talent, 30%, on-stage interview, 25%, and evening wear, 20%. The judges were former boxer Lila Ali, country star Jesse James Decker, former American Idol judge Randy Jackson, journalist Soledad O'Brien, radio personality Bobby Bones, singer Carney Wilson and Dry Bar founder Ali Webb. Former Miss America Cara Mundt was there. Despite stirring up more controversy for the organization last month, Mundt, the 2018 title holder, sat in the audience during the show and appeared on stage to a standing ovation when she crowned Franklin. Mundt recently trashed Carlson and the organization's leadership by accusing it of silencing her and bullying her during her reign. Miss New York won. Franklin brought the title back to the Empire State for the seventh time in Miss America history. After her father was diagnosed with cancer, Franklin entered the competition so she could find a way to pay for school. At age 5, she wrote her first song, which she later performed during a press conference. But for the talent competition, the classically trained opera singer who studied at the University of North Carolina School of the Arts performed an operatic selection from La Boheme. She also focused on equal opportunity and education in her interview answers. Franklin welcomed this year's changes and told the Associated Press she was glad the swimsuit competition was eliminated, because it enabled her to eat a little more. I've already seen so many young women reaching out to me personally as Miss New York asking how they can get involved because I think they feel more empowered that they don't have to do things such as walk in a swimsuit for a scholarship, she said. And I'm happy that I didn't have to do so to win this title tonight because I'm more than just that. And all these women on stage are more than just that. As Miss America 2019, she'll promote her social impact initiative advocating for the arts and work as the National Goodwill Ambassador for Children's Miracle Network Hospitals, a nonprofit organization dedicated to saving and improving the lives of children by raising funds for children's hospitals. Miss Connecticut and Miss Louisiana were the runners-up. Miss Connecticut Bridget Mary OEI, the Irish step dancing candidate, was the first runner-up and earned a $25,000 scholarship. Miss Louisiana Holly Conway won a $20,000 scholarship. The organization also doled out $5,000 STEM scholarships to Miss Massachusetts Gabriella Tavares, Miss Montana Laura Haller and Miss Nevada Alexis Hilts. Recipients of the Women in Business scholarships were Miss Hawaii Penelope NG Pack and Miss South Dakota Carrie Wintle, who also earned $5,000 apiece.